Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me tell you about Mac Clipboard Managers. MacMost is supported by more than 500 viewers just like you. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So those of you who have been watching me for a while know that I'm one of the few voices out there that tells you not to clutter your Mac with all sorts of system extensions and helper apps. I personally don't use anything like window managers or any special search tools or things like that. I believe that macOS has a lot of great features built in, and it's worth it to take the time to learn how to use it instead of falling back to using third-party apps that clutter and perhaps even slow down your Mac. However, there is one type of third-party tool that I do recommend that you install on your Mac, and that's a clipboard manager. So normally when you copy and paste, the last thing you copied is the thing that's pasted in. A clipboard manager allows you to go back and look at your copy history and paste something else besides the very last thing that you copied. This is fantastic for productivity if you do any kind of writing, any kind at all, even just writing email messages or posting comments online. Being able to access a clipboard history is very useful. And fortunately, you don't have to look any further than the Mac App Store for a whole bunch of great clipboard managers. So there's really no risk in installing one. Plus, a lot of them are free. To find a clipboard manager, go to the Mac App Store app and search for Clipboard Manager. Then you'll get a list of results. There are a lot of different clipboard managers. Some of these are free. Some you pay for one time. Others have subscriptions or in-app purchases. Each has a different set of features and works in a slightly different way, but they all more or less do the same thing. You'll remember a list of recent things that you've copied, so you can paste not just the last thing you copied, but go back and paste things you previously copied. I'm going to show you three different ones here, starting with Cloud Clip Manager, the one I happen to use. Cloud Clip Manager is a pretty basic one. It just copies text and remembers that, but it does save the list in iCloud. So since I have two Macs, a laptop and a desktop, I can copy things on one and then see those same items on the other. After it's running, I just see it as a menu bar icon right here at the top. When I copy something, it remembers it. So let's copy something here. And if I go and click there, you can see it remembers what I copied. Now that's nothing special. The payoff is when you copy another thing. So for instance, I'll copy another word here. And now when I click in there, you can see I've got both of those things remembered. I can continue to copy different things. And now I can look at the list and it's getting quite long. Normally I'd only be able to paste the very last thing that I copied. But now I can actually select from this list. So for instance, if I were to paste, it would paste the last thing that I copied. But I could go into the menu here and select a previous item that I copied and then paste that. Let's look at all the options. There's a clear menu here and I can clear everything or a specific item. I can set this to open at login so I don't have to remember to run it every time I reboot. I can set a clip limit to the number to save, so 15 is the default, but I can go up to 50. If I turn off automatically add clips, what will happen is if I copy something, I can go up here and see that I could add it manually. It won't automatically add to the list. So this will allow me to highly customize this list because I'm only adding very specific things to it. I can set it to ignore one password. So for instance, if I copy things from one password to paste somewhere else, usually that's pretty secure information, and this way it won't save it in the list. And there's a hotkey. The hotkey simply brings up this menu so I can use it with the keyboard. So for instance, I can use it Control Option Command V, and you can see it brings the menu right up, and I can use the arrow keys, go down and select something and then paste. Everything's pretty simple. If I install this on my second Mac and I'm using the same Apple ID, I should see the same items appear there. Another one I used to use for a long time, and it's a little bit more technical, is Flycut. So if I were to open that, I'd see it appear here in the menu just like Cloud Clip. And it works in a similar way. So if I were to copy a bunch of different things and then look in here, you could see those items appear. One thing I like about Flycut is if you select the item, it simply pastes it in automatically. I don't select it and then paste. There's also a way to search for things in here. I can clear. And there's a pretty good set of preferences here, including being able to sync settings and the clippings over iCloud, and set a hotkey. And the hotkey works a little different than selecting something from the menu. So for instance, if I want to insert something here, I'll use Shift Command V, and you can see it brings up this little overlay here. And I can use the arrow keys to move between the different items and then release to paste that in. In Preferences, I can do things like make that stay so sticky. So you just do Shift Command V and then it stays there until you select the item that you want. I can also set it not to copy from password fields and set some rules for that. And I can also set the appearance of that overlay as well. So you can see it's a little more technical here, but it works basically the same way. A third example is Copy Clip. It's free but it has a built-in promotion for apps from that same developer. But it comes up with the same kind of menu here. If I copy some things and then look, I'll see here the list. Under Preferences I can set how many to remember, whether to start at startup, a list of apps for exceptions so I can exclude things like password managers. Now if you go into here and you select something, it doesn't immediately paste it in. You have to do Command V. And these shortcuts, all they do is when you select the menu there, you can then use the shortcut at that point to select the item and then you have to paste. So you'll find more features in some of these other clipboard managers if you're willing to pay. For instance, the ability to copy images or parts of images as well as just text, rich text of course, and some other things as well. Some of them work in different ways, giving you visual representations of what you have in the clipboard rather than just a quick pull down menu of it. So look through the Mac App Store and pick out a clipboard manager that fits your needs, or just try out one of the free ones that I've shown. I think you'll find clipboard managers immediately become an essential tool on your Mac. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.